Hello, Madcappers. Welcome to another lesson in hat making. And today we're going to make a fabulous summer bucket hat. So there's a free PDF pattern available for this project. There'll be a link in the description below, as well as a full pattern in 6 head sizes for a nominal fee. So you can make this hat in so many different ways. You can add some lace to fancy it up. All the pattern links and the supplies that I use in this video are in the description below. So many options with this hat, folks. It's a real winner. And I'd like to thank our subscriber Anne for suggesting that we use a shoelace instead of the cord that I feature in this video, as well as some of my other videos. The shoelace link is in the description below, and it comes in a bag with lots of colors. You can also substitute the brim and use a wider one, and we used a wider brim in an earlier video, and I'll put that link below as well. So the band of our hat has 2 notches. And those notches we use for a variety of trim options and design features, including placing our cord on the band or making a belt loop so we can have a scarf on our hat. And that was covered in the sunblocker part 2. But the belt loops are worth revisiting. I will go over that briefly in this video as well. We also use those notches to mark where we're going to place some elastic inside the back of our hat in the inside of our lining piece, creating a very comfortable custom fit. In our lining, we'll add a small piece of narrow elastic that's 1/8 of an inch wide, or 3 millimeters wide, about 7 inches or 18 centimeters long. And we're going to use 2 different kinds of stabilizers in this project. We use a medium weight, one-sided fusible, and a heavyweight sew-in interfacing. And I'm also going to use this poly cotton broadcloth to make the lining for my band and the top. And the summer bucket hat has 3 pattern pieces. The top is in 2 sections and has a curve in the center to match the curve at the top of our heads. The hat also has a band and a brim. And for the band on the koala bear print, I just did the hat plain without a cord, but with the elastic in the lining for fit. I'm going to add a drawstring in the back of the hat that I'm going to show you how to make today, or you can use some of that shoestring that has end caps that make it easy to slip a toggle on the end. Now my cord is about 36 inches or 92 centimeters to start, and I'll put that in the description below as well. The brim is stabilized with the medium fusible on the back of each side of the brim, but if you want it to be extra firm, you can add an extra piece of sew-in stabilizer in between those 2 layers as well. For this project, I'm using cotton linen from Spoonflower, which is a medium weight fabric, so I'm just going to use the medium weight fusible on each side of my brim piece, and I've cut them out in the order that they're going to be attached, so I'll fuse everything all at once and it's all ready to go. Stacking them like this gives me perfectly matched pieces, which I find really easy, and I'm just going to apply my heat and my steam now to fuse, and I'll fuse one side, turn it over, and just add the same process to the opposite side, and what was 4 layers now becomes 2. And to prep for the sewing, I'm going to turn one piece over so that the 2 pieces of my brim are right sides together, and I'll clip along that inside curve because I'm going to work on the outside curve when I eventually get over to the sewing machine. And with my brims, I always like to have a really nice clean back seam. So this is the way that I sew my brims. I'm just going to start my seam inside from each end about 3 inches or 7.5 centimeters. And that piece that I cut out from the center of my brim works perfectly for the top of my hat. So I folded my top outside piece in half, so right sides together, stacking as I cut, and now I have my top outside and my lining all ready to sew. And our band is made from 4 layers, so I'm going to start by cutting my lining piece, and that lining piece is going to get a piece of elastic eventually. And I like to cut the pieces for my band all at once, just like the brim, so they are all the edges are going to match perfectly. And I'm layering a heavyweight piece of stabilizer and then a medium fusible layer of stabilizer. And that medium fusible, the glue is going to be right up against the back side of the outside of my band. And in this case, my hat, if I haven't mentioned it yet, is these fun surfing doggies. four band layers cut, I'll set aside that lining layer, and I'm going to fuse the medium weight onto the back of my outside piece, my surfing doggies, and now I have two band pieces, and I'm going to sew them together with a decorative row of sewing. I place a row of sewing in the sort of the midway point of the band. It's about 1 1/4 inch up from the bottom, or 3 centimeters, and I just find that it holds it all nicely together. You can use a straight stitch line if you'd like. And now I'm going to attach the ends of my cord to my band, and I'm working on the back side of my band with the cord underneath on the right side, and you'll notice I'm using those notches to place the cord ends. I use an edge stitch for that initial row of sewing, and now I'm just going to finish edge stitching this band. I'll go all the way around on all four sides. And now I'm going to join my back seams together, so my two smaller ends together, and I'll use my normal seam width of 3/8 inch or 1 centimeter right sides together. Finger press open. And finish with a top stitch, a stitch up one side and down the other side of that seam, leaving a flat, comfortable seam at the back of the hat. To make the hat look completely different, we can add belt loops. And I did that decorative stitch about 1 1/4 inch or 3 centimeters up from the bottom edge of my band. And now I'm going to use those notches to place two pieces of grosgrain ribbon to make my belt loops. And I went over this quite extensively in the video called The Sunblocker Part 2. So if you want to go back and watch that, I will put a link up in this top corner for that video so you can see how I did the belt loops with a bit more explanation. And as you can see, again, I'm working from the back of the band, and my belt loops are pinned to the front of my band, so they're underneath my sewing. I'm just catching the bottom edge of the ribbon as I do that edge stitch around the bottom of the band. We're gonna fold that ribbon in half to make a belt loop. So I'm going to mark a place on the ribbon where I'm going to make that fold. And I'm gonna sew up to those lines from the bottom of the band and make a small rectangle of sewing to hold that piece of ribbon in place before I fold the other part of the ribbon on top of it. And you can decide how deep you want to make your belt loops and just make a little mark. I think that makes it a lot easier to do this next step of sewing. And so now I'm going to sew up one side of the ribbon, and at that chalk mark I'm going to pivot with my needle in, sew across very carefully, back and forth, back and forth. That's my fold line. Pivot again, back down to the bottom edge. And once I cut those ends away, I am going to remove my pin, fold over the ribbon, sew it down in place, adding it to the rest of the band and creating a nice little channel. That's going to mean the scarf is going to fit close to the hat because that belt loop is firmly attached, but I have a little channel that I can put some sort of trim through. And I will repeat on the other side. And once the belt loops are finished, just continue edge stitching that heavyweight stabilizer to the back of your fabric. And now belt loop piece with an edge stitch, and sew the back edges of the band together with your usual seam width of 3/8 inch or 1 centimeter, finger press, and finish with that beautiful top stitching. And I'm gonna show you how to make another band. And this one, we're gonna add a little bit of that beautiful lingerie lace to the front just to dress up the hat a little bit and make it even more special. I didn't do my decorative stitch on this one. I'm just going to start with an edge stitch at the bottom because I'm going to sew that lingerie lace on in two places. And it's going to end up one of the rows of sewing is going to be about where that decorative stitch would be, but I'll start at the bottom. And as I attach it, I'm working on the wrong side with my lace underneath on the right side. I'm just pulling it ever so slightly. I started out with a piece that was about the same length as my band, and when I finish, I have about 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters left at the one end that I'll trim off. But because it's stretchy, I'm not going to try and pull it too tight because I don't want to distort my band, but you see that it fits into that curve nicely. And I've just put a few pins in to hold it, I'll do a stitch up the edge there before I trim, and I'm going to use my magnetic seam guide, my best friend, to help set the place where, again, I'm going to work from the back, but I'll figure out from the front how wide this seam has to be up from the bottom edge. In order to catch the lace just towards the top, and there you have it. It's pretty easy and it looks fantastic. And again, I'll finish up by sewing up the back seam and doing that top stitch up one side, down the other. And I'll just finish because I forgot to do the edge stitch at the top. But now we're ready to work on our band lining, and I'm going to show you how I put in the elastic using those notches. And I have sewed the back seam with the two ends together, and I'm just going to do a top stitch down one side so that on the right side, or on the side that's closest to your head, you'll have a seam with the top stitching on one side to keep the seam flat. And now I'm working on the wrong side. With the raw edge of the seam looking at me, I'm going to find a place to place my elastic, and for me, that's about 2 centimeters or 3/4 of an inch up from the bottom edge of the back of my lining band. Starting at one notch and sewing over top of the raw edge of the back seam towards the other notch and stretching the elastic out evenly as I go. From one notch to the other, elastic added, and now I have a nice stretchy piece of lining for my hat. And now it's time to work on the top. Right sides together, I'm going to sew down that center seam with my usual 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter wide seam from one end to the other. And the ends of those seams are going to be my center front and my center back, and I'm going to repeat on the lining piece as well. So now I'm going to end up doing a top stitch on the lining and on the top, but on the lining, I'll just do a single top stitch, moving that seam to one side and sewing over top. And on the outside piece, my surfing dogs, I'm going to finger press that seam open as best I can and sew the two raw edges of the seam down on either side with a decorative top stitch. If you want to make this fun, you could use a very contrast color of thread. For me, I'm just sort of blending it in with a thread that's just gonna not really be that noticeable. So up one side, back down the other, and you end up with a beautiful top that has a slight curve, and it's gonna fit nicely into our band and not produce a seam joining the band to the top of the hat that's puckered or, you know, wavy and out of place. It's just going to fit nicely like a structured, look like a blocked hat actually. So I'll finish off with an edge stitch joining my top outside piece with my top lining. And I'll bring the two ends of my center seam together. Just add a little clip there to make it easier for me to determine the center sides. And I'll cut a small notch just so I have 4 points now that I can match when I'm sewing my top to my band. And I'll make matching notches on my band piece as well. So a center front, and I'll add a center front on the bottom part as well. But just on the top, I'll bring the center notch into the back seam at the top and create 2 notches on each one on each side, so I can actually ease that top in easily when it comes time to sew them all together. And now I'm going to work on my brim. So working on the brim now, I'm going to sew the 2 right sides of the brim together along that outside edge, but starting at that mark that I made when I was cutting, that's about 3 inches from each end, and ending at the other mark. And then once I've done that, I'm going to stop my sewing and I'll clip the raw ends together, the two matching the ends on each side of the brim. So the ends from the top section of the brim together and the ends from the underside of the brim together. And I'll sew with my regular seam width of 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter and sew those 2 ends together before I finish sewing the outside edge of my brim. And I pull them out, and what I'll do is I'll open up those seams so that I sew over top of them. They're open, they're flat, they're comfortable. and I'll just close the rest of my brim outside edge, taking care as I sew over top of those two back seams that the seams are open underneath my presser foot. That's how it should look, folks. Now you can go around this outside edge with scissors and make small clips along that big curve of your brim to help with turning it right side out. Or you can do what I do and use a serger to finish the raw edge. I find that it just helps to compress the fabric together and gives me a nice edge that I can pull out and roll to get a nice, crisp, rounded edge of my brim all the way around my hat. And I use my fingers to roll out that fabric to get that nice edge. And then I'll go around the hat and top stitch. Now with a bucket hat, you can add as many rows of top stitching as you want right up to the edge of the brim, or you can just do one row, and that's what I'm gonna do here. But I did two rows on my koala hat. But I know that lots of bucket hats in the industry have rows of top stitching all the way up to the band. So I'm just gonna finish up the brim now by sewing the layers together on the inside of the brim as well. And I will add my madcap hat label. And then I will cut a center notch at the front center of the brim on that inside curve, which is gonna make it easier for me to work in and ease in the band. And now we're ready for the fun to start. We get to do the assembly. So I'm clipping the right sides together at the back of the hat, the outside of the band, but the outside or the top layer of my brim. And I'll start at the back with my regular seam width of 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter and ease in my band all the way around, matching my notches. And there you have it, the start of a bucket hat. And I take care too to make sure I don't sew over my cord. And now on the other side, so sandwiching the brim in between, I am going to add my lining. So the band lining, the right side is facing the right side of the underside of our hat. And I'm matching up those band notches as well as I go along, and I'm following along the same seam that I used to join the outside of our band to the top layer of our brim. And I'll just work all the way around and pull out the band lining with the elastic as I come to those parts in my construction and over the back seam, and all looks great. Pulling out the lining and the band now, the wrong sides are together, and I'm just gonna finish up by closing up that top, sewing those two layers together with an edge stitch. And I should mention that my edge stitch is just the width of my presser foot, maybe 1/4 inch or 6 millimeters. Matching up back seams and front seams and side notches, I'm gonna clip my top to the top of my band, right sides together. And I'll remove these clips as I sew, but doing this first gives me a good idea of how well the top is going to fit into my band. And if you find that it's not fitting very well, you can make some adjustments at this point in your sewing. And I do take my time when I'm sewing the top to the rest of the hat. I go around carefully. My seam width is 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter. My magnetic seam guide does the heavy lifting because it gives me a nice firm edge to put my raw edges on the right side and work them together so that the raw edge of my top and the raw edge of my band underneath sort of meet up at the edge of that magnetic guide. But just take your time, match notches, and then voila, here you are. You're at the end point. You can just use a serger to take care of those raw edges, or pinking shears, or a zigzag stitch. Turn it right side out, check your work, give yourself a pat on the back, and you can decide at this point to finish and add a toggle if you've put a cord on, or just finish. I'm going to do one last step. I'm just going to sew that seam that's inside at the top down to the side of the hat, just making this a smoother curve for the top of the hat. And I'm using a special foot that has a deeper side on that left side than on the right side, and helps me move all those layers of fabric over to that right side. This is an optional step, folks. You don't have to do this. I do this for my hats, but you don't need to do it. The hat will be fine if you don't. But there you have it. I'm just gonna add the toggle now. And when I do that, I cut my ends of my cord, tie the ends into a knot so they don't fray, tie the cord into a bow, and yes, here we are. We're finished. Yay! Now, if you have questions or comments, leave them below, with or without a cord. The hat is great. I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you so much to our Patreon supporters and our channel members. You guys are the true producers of these videos, and if you want to leave us a super thanks, we are grateful. Like and subscribe to the channel as well if you haven't already. Questions and comments, leave them below. I answer them quickly. Thank you so much for watching. This video is dedicated to the memory of our beloved Heidi. She loved the water, hence the theme of the surfing dogs. Rest in peace, Heidi. We're going to miss you so much.